登记记录出现异常。通讯处通知，你的电话将在两小时后停止服务。
Every person with a mobile phone receives such calls on a daily basis.
查询原因，广东话请按一，普通话复二。
It is also possible for you to receive various phishing messages or emails.
過往香港十年裏面咧，嗰個網上嗰電腦嘅罪案咧，其實咧係多咗差唔多十倍嘅。
唔單止係香港啦，全世界嘅執法機構都係面對住呢一個挑戰，因為互聯網其實除咗係隱蔽性之外啦，其實佢都仲係一個跨地域性。
出事前我聽過啦，就係知道睇到電視。嗰啲騙案話投資幾多輸咗幾百萬啊，過千萬啊，我覺得都即係好似好兒戲。
當我 online 做緊客做緊 transaction， 咁好自然就會有 one time password 啦。咁其實你撳一下咧，就已經 cut 咗上嗰個網頁度噶啦。
As innumerable deception tactics emerge, what precautions should citizens take?Technologies are advancing rapidly. While online transactions are convenient, fraudsters are constantly seeking new ways to defraud people. Crime reports totaled 42,923 in the first half of 2023, an increase of 36.5% over the same period in 2022. Traditional crimes like burglary and assault have declined, while deception and blackmail are growing rapidly.According to the latest police department figures, the number of deception cases in the first half of 2023 increased 52.1% compared to the same period in 2022 to 18,743. The increase is astonishing. Among them, over 70% were online deceptions.
好多市民都習慣咗喺屋企在家工作啊，在家學習啊，或者係消費啊、娛樂啊、交友都係離唔開互聯網啊。因此咧，騙徒亦都係將佢哋嘅板塊轉移到網上。
According to the research by an international credit card company in March 2023, the keywords winning prizes, exclusive offers, and free gifts are often used in titles that are likely to scam people. People are more likely to believe a scam if it contains pictures of celebrities.Mr. Kong, who doesn't want to appear on camera, used to work in the finance industry. During the pandemic, he attempted to develop income sources by investing in virtual currencies. He didn't expect to come across a fake website.
I'm a normal Hong Kong person, too. I like Facebook, Instagram, and I'm going to put some ads on there. I'm going to introduce the product. I'm going to introduce some政治人物啦，四大天王其中一個啊，嗰啲騙徒好犀利，用曬嗰啲名人去做效應啦、啊。加上咧個網站咧，用好多財經報導啦，話呢個係潮流嚟嘅。跟住就咁樣佢就登記咗，跟住就喺第二日咧，佢哋就overseas 有個電話打入嚟就話你係登記咗呢個我哋嘅會籍介紹翻嗰個產品俾我認識嘅當時。
The virtual currency market has been booming in recent years, and cyber criminals have taken advantage of this to pose as investment advisors. Mr. Kong was persuaded to use his credit card to cash out and purchase Bitcoin. It's a good return on investment. Within the first few days, he had made 10 to 20% profit.
開頭佢就建議就即係5,000蚊先嘅，5,000蚊美金嘅。當時如果你話幾千蚊咁咪我覺得都可以再加添加住嘅。咁但係只係我同佢講，我即係我同對方講咗話要提到錢，我先相信你嗰個回報嘅咁樣咯。咁就佢應承喺25號咧就俾翻個最後嗰個回報俾我嘅，即係由第一日碌卡6月14號到6月25號咧。總共都係11日，佢應承佢俾翻錢我啊嘛。
With the benefits he'd seen, Mr. Kong hoped to make more. During this period, the scammer repeatedly called and texted to induce him to increase his investment amount. He even told Mr. Kong he needed to invest more than 100,000 US dollars to withdraw money. In total, Mr. Kong used 5 credit cards for the transaction. However, when he wanted to exit with profits, At the end, Mr. Kong lost approximately 750,000 Hong Kong dollars, which he has not been able to recoup. Investment frauds are emerging. People's greed is exploited to make this possible. Globally, there are hundreds of virtual asset trading platforms, many of which are located overseas and are difficult to trace. Even if it's a local transaction, defrauded money is sometimes quickly transferred from the fraudster's account to a third party or fourth party account.
我哋睇到好多呢啲騙徒咧，都係嚟自境外嘅。譬如話佢哋喺境外裏邊用境外嘅服務供應商啦，或者係啲錢係會係轉到去海外嘅銀行户口收錢啦，又或者佢哋係海外註冊一啲域名去行騙啦等等。
Cyber crimes increased in Hong Kong from around 5,500 in 2017.To nearly 23,000 cases in 2022, a fourfold increase. With the increasing popularity of electronic payments, a variety of related cases are emerging. In addition to investment fraud, romance scams, naked chat blackmail, impersonation of government officials, and online employment fraud are also common. Many victims lost large sums of money to fraud.As cybersecurity experts pointed out, online and telephone scams have much lower costs for scammers than traditional ones. Phishing attacks, for example, can also target a large number of people with just a click of a button. It is possible for a scammer to make large sums of money as long as a few people take the bait.
In 以前嘅社會裏邊咧，好多個騙案咧都係需要咧嗰個被騙嘅人咧，又或者嗰啲匪徒，又或者係騙人嗰啲人咧，係要同你咧喺一個同一個地方，有一個叫做直接個接觸，佢先至可以騙到你嘅。咁但係喺呢個互聯網嘅世界咧，就等於咧好似我哋係一條細魚，喺一個大嘅池塘裏邊咁。一般嚟講咧，啲騙徒咧都係要揾一個好接觸得到我哋市民嘅方式咧，去做一啲虛假嘅資訊，令到我哋市民覺得，咦？呢個資訊我哋回應咗之後咧，會有一啲好處喎。譬如話，話你中咗獎啊，又或者近來我哋香港政府派呢個消費券，佢哋都會用一啲咁樣嘅最流行嘅一啲嘅話題咧，嚟引起我哋市民嘅注意。
In addition to playing on people's psychological needs for luring, many messages contain hyperlinks or attachments, which are known as malware.Clicking on unknown links and attachments is like setting a fox to keep geese, allowing malware to get into our devices. Confidential information, including credit card numbers and passwords, may be stolen without the owner's knowledge. It is even possible to steal the identity of the victim to send messages, etc. With the popularization of artificial intelligence, we have gained a great deal of convenience. Among these technologies,Deep fake can render the appearance of a person, even a celebrity, in a short video that resembles the real. It has been discussed that some related technologies can change faces and voices in real time.
究竟嚟緊會唔會呢個成為一個大趨勢咧？咁好難講啊！喺今時今日嘅科技，要真係做到好流暢地進行一個即係深藝嘅短片啊，或者實時扮聲扮畫嘅話咧，咁都仲有一啲門檻，或者需要一啲比較高嘅運算嘅一啲速度啦。如果接到一啲視像通話啦，咁啊懷疑對方嘅身份嘅時候咧，咁其實可以叫對方啦，咁即係用一手指掃佢塊面，掃一掃。咁如果係用人工智能深藝技術的話咧，咁就可能咧會出現模糊。因為咧會有一啲突如其來嘅轉變啦，咁啊電腦佢需要更加多嘅時間去運算啦。
In the past 2 years, phishing text messages have become more prevalent. Occasionally, organizations claim to have been mimicked and sent random texts asking recipients to visit a fake website and request to fill out credit card info.
釣魚騙案咧就係我哋今年網罪科喺今年一月咧新監察嘅一個類別嚟嘅。咁因為我哋睇到一路都有上升嘅趨勢啦。咁其實釣魚騙案顧名思義就係騙徒就抌一啲利出去啦。咁所以就願者上釣。市民咧收到呢啲短信啦，可能佢係假冒一啲公共機構啦，假冒一啲真正存在嘅商户啦，或者係一啲平台。咁佢哋信以為真咧，就會 click 入去裡面嘅一條連結裡面。
In February 2023, Ms. Lee received a text message stating that her membership points were about to expire. She clicked on the link, unaware that it was a scam.
月底之前要用嗰啲積分佢，如果唔係就會冇曬啦咁啊。咁而我本身因為用嘅電話嘅台咧，就真係 link with the club 嘅。咁所以變相咧，就我嗰刻就覺得哦 ，OK， 咁有呢個 reminder， 咁啊去睇啦。咁我見我啲分都有喺度，咁咪換咗啲我覺得相對地我都有少少用途嘅嘢啦。咁跟住，因為佢係除咗用積分之外都有用錢啦。咁我揀完禮物咧，下一版咁我咪入 credit card 照咯。當我 online 做緊 transaction， 咁好自然就會有 one time password 啦。咁其實你撳一下咧，就已經 pass 咗上嗰個網頁度噶啦。
Ms. Lee wasn't aware that such a convenient move could allow the scammer to successfully link her credit card to her e-wallet.
咁但係有一日咧，就無啦啦收到一個短信，咁我就以為咧係一個。即係呃人嘅信息啦，咁樣，因為佢嗰度寫咧就話我哋咪做緊一個咩嘅 transaction， 碌咗幾多錢？如果係嘅話，你就唔係你嘅話就撳個二字啦，咁樣。咁我唔肯定，咁撳咗出去之後會有啲咩發生啊嘛。咁我嗰刻咧，其實我睇到呢個 SMS， 我又 log in 翻我嘅 online banking 啦。咁嗰刻睇咧係真係冇嘅。咁點知就係隔咗一日，咁嗰啲 transaction 咧就喺個 e-banking 度見到啦。咁就發現咧碌咗三條數啦，咁。分別一條係40,000，第二條40,000，第三條20,000咁樣啦，咁就差唔多接近100,000蚊嘅費用啦。
Ms. Lee believes that the card issuing bank did not do a good job and that there were security loopholes. Edward Lung, who has been following up on credit card fraud cases, has assisted Ms. Lee during this period. A half-year struggle resulted in the bank bearing only 1/10 of the losses.
銀行很多時咧，佢哋就用一個叫做嚴重疏忽嘅一個指控嚟去話嗰個卡主係佢嘅錯，跟住無論大小幾百萬以至到幾萬蚊嘅錢，都要嗰個苦主自己嚟去負責。但係事實上點為之嚴重疏忽喺市面上係未有一個好清晰嘅界定。最近金管局就出咗一個指引，如果嗰個卡主咧係有盡力嚟去履行好佢自己作為卡主嘅一個責任，即係話。唔見咗張卡，馬上去報警報失嘅話咧，呢啲都係應該銀行去考慮嘅一啲條件嚟去決定佢係咪真係嚴重疏忽。
Edward Lung also believes citizens themselves should also be alert, pay more attention to bank messages, and protect personal and credit card information, especially one-time passwords. The Hong Kong Monetary Authority has received 519 complaints about fraud and financial crimes in the first 5 months of 2023, which is close to the total in 2022.
咁亦都係見到呢個情況咧，就我哋金管局同埋銀行界咧，其實一路都好著緊，就係去希望提升銀行服務嗰個保安措施啦，同埋進行多啲消費者嘅教育，咁希望加強消費者嘅保障。
In late June 2023, the Hong Kong Monetary Authority and the Hong Kong Association of Banks launched the Anti-Scam Consumer Protection Charter. 23 card-issuing banks and 15 merchant institutions committed not to send instant electronic messages, such as SMS, WhatsApp, WeChat, etc., to customers with embedded hyperlinks to request personal and credit card information online. Representatives from the participating institutions reminded citizens that they should raise their awareness about preventative measures.
當 你自己本身一啲嘅個人資料，好似你一個數碼嘅一條匙咁，你就要睇緊。你冇理由將你自己屋企條門匙四圍擺俾人，或者四圍 copy 俾人噶咁。就係數碼 key 睇緊啲，咁拎前要三思。
所以咧，我特別提醒我哋嘅客户嘅朋友咧，喺任何情況之下，都唔好將自己嘅 one-time password 咧俾任何嘅第三者。甚至如果係你自己輸入 one-time password 咧，都應該要核證。
As a result of the increase in unauthorized credit card transactions, Sun Yu, chairman of the Hong Kong Association of Banks, stated on the occasion that the industry would continue to improve online services.
一直以来，银行业界十分重视客户资讯保护及支付交易的安全性，并持续在交易授权、侦测可疑交易及推送客户通知等方面采取措施，以保障信用卡持卡人的利益。银行工会于今年第一季度成立专责小组，与会员银行紧密合作。
The association also highlighted enhanced measures such as allowing customers to set credit limits for card-not-present transactions, suspending their credit cards instantly with a single click, as well as other features are supposed to be fully implemented in the second half of
2023。咁新措施咧嘅例子就包括一客户咧能够咧按住自己嘅需要啦去选择究竟系咪会透过信用卡做一个无卡交易啦，同埋调整翻相关嘅一啲交易限额。而当客户咧佢真系去 将卡去绑定去一啲嘅非接触式嘅流动支付服务嘅时候咧，银行咧亦都会进行一个额外嘅认证，去确定咧客户呢一个嘅发出嘅绑定嘅信用卡嘅指示咧系正确嘅。银行业界咧都会全面提升翻网上银行啦，同埋手机银行嘅功能，提供翻一个一键锁卡嘅功能咧，令到客户咧可以有一个保障，同时亦都可以增加翻佢哋嘅自主性。
To
promote anti-fraud information, a political party cooperates with the Eastern District Police by distributing leaflets in the neighborhood regularly. They also posted notices in shopping malls and residential lobbies. Through the weekly updating of fraud numbers and trends analysis, they hope to alert and remind the community.
咁我哋就可以话俾东区嘅市民听，其实喺你哋屋企附近都系发生紧同样嘅事情。咁样嘅话咧，就可以希望喺未来咧系可以减低嗰个诈骗案嘅数字，亦都让到佢哋更加警惕。嗱，我哋睇翻喺内地嗰度嚟咧，东莞因为做完一个动作之后咧，嗰个镇区系减咗一半。 其實我哋係需要多管齊下，無論係線上或者係線下咧，我哋都係要做一個宣傳。固然線上嘅話咧，呢個就要政府係要行前一步，線下就係我哋民間亦都係要多行幾步。To
increase public awareness, the police has intensified its efforts to prevent fraud.
凡事冇免費，免費往往最貴，真假短信你要分得清。
Through publicity activities, the Anti-Fraud Coordination Center informs the public about how to deal with messages from unknown sources.
來歷不明短信,不要回覆,虛假連結,不要亂click! 發現白撞嘅信息,千祈唔回覆,同埋一定要封鎖佢。提醒身邊嘅人,打1822問下。
This 24-hour inquiry hotline can provide real-time advice to help seekers and may even provide early intervention in fraud cases. The center even worked with local financial institutes in establishing a stop payment mechanism to reduce the victim's losses.
咁係1822呢個熱線咧，已經收到超過20萬個求助㗎啦。咁當中16萬個來電咧係嚟自市民嘅一啲查詢啦，可能佢遇到唔同嘅情況咧，就可以打去呢個熱線睇下佢咪遇到一個騙案。而我哋咧都成功阻止咗超過2000單唔同種類嘅騙案。
In October 2022, the police launched the scam meter, hoping to enhance citizens' ability to distinguish online information authenticity. By entering the website address, phone number, or account number, etc., one can check for traps or fraud risks. The search results will be color-coded in accordance with the alert level.
所以咧，我覺得提升全民嘅數碼素養係非常之緊要嘅，同埋要佢哋養成一個凡事去進行一個事實查證，即係 fact check 嘅習慣。咁另外，其實我哋同銀行業界咧都有好多嘅協作啦，譬如話我哋嚟緊年底咧會同轉數快咧會有一個連接嘅，咁啊同呢個防騙伺服器連接。咁當市民咧如果係透過轉數快平台轉錢， 咁如果收款账号系已经喺防骗伺服器里边系标签咗系同一啲诈骗嘅陷阱有关咧，咁佢喺嗰个确认嘅页面，佢会有一个警示嘅，咁啊提醒市民转钱前要小心嘅。
依家喺24/7嘅網絡安全嘅運作中心。
In addition to increasing individual vigilance, many companies have enhanced their network security. This day, the Computer Society visited the center's facilities.
即係呢個中心就收集曬所有香港好多公司嘅一啲資料，咁你哋就做一個監控。
Cybersecurity experts advise us to prevent phishing sites and malicious programs. Enhancing digital literacy is of the utmost importance. Whether we use a computer or a mobile phone, we must actively close network security loopholes.
第一就係喺嗰個手機或者電腦上嗰、那個嗰、那個軟件嘅翻新啦，呢、這個好重要啦。因為翻新咧就可以包含埋一啲堵塞咗漏洞嘅軟件喺裏邊啦。第二就係話如果係有啲防毒軟件，又或者而家現時咧有啲叫做反惡意軟件嘅軟件咧，都可以裝喺我哋嘅電腦上高，咁變咗咧佢哋都可以幫助我哋咧係去將我哋被騙或者用惡意軟件令到我哋有損失咧減低。
As lifestyles change, digitalization has become an indisputable reality. You are your first line of defense against fraud.
今次對我打擊都幾大嘅，因為嗰個額都唔係一個細嘅數字啦。咁所以我嚟緊對，即係如果唔係一個面對面嘅簽帳，我係唔會做咯。我對所有海外簽帳嗰個戒心提高咗咯。
Whether you have been tricked or not,You should always remain vigilant. It's easy to slack off when we consider it commonplace. You will lose big things, especially if you are greedy for small gains.
我自己覺得啦，如果收到懷疑嘅短信咧，可以先即係真係 check 清楚啦。依家方便係為主，但係冇貪方便，直接喺個短信度撳嗰條 link。